everyone. My name is Lisa. I haven't done a video for a couple days, but I wanted to tell you guys that I actually got some new makeup. Well, I don't know, not necessarily new, but I did get the Shade and Light Contour Palette by Kat Von D. I have been kind of using it for the last couple days. It's a nice one. I did get the new Basket Case Eyeliner by Kat Von D and Billy Joe Armstrong, the collab that they did. And that's actually what the video is going to be about. I did get more tattoo liner. It's also important. And I also wanted to get this, goodness gracious, I'm studying my words. Stuttering. I got the Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara, which I've heard so much great about. But the thing is, I'm not sure if it's actually better than sex. You're gonna have to put this bad boy to the test. It probably will be a couple years, just saying. But anyways, please, I hope you enjoy the video and continue to watch. So, here we are again. We're going to get into the video. So, I kind of wanted to point out a couple things before really getting into this. So, here's the little box, the basket case. It's kind of cool because it's Kat Von D and Billy Joe's, like their signatures on the box, which is kind of cool. And they also have it on the eyeliner as well. But I wanted to point out something that Kat Von D has kind of been an advocate for. So Kat Von D says, you know, everything about America, like he's, you know, against Trump. She's against Trump and all of that. And I just wanted to point out something that, you know, she goes, you know, America, you know, because when someone won her Satan Sinners, like, she had a photo shoot or something that, like, you know, her Satan Sinners, when it was, like, her, when her eyeshadow palette was just about to release, they're like, whoever wins, they get, like, a $500 gift card to Sephora or something like that, and also they got invited to her Satan Sinners party, and all this other shit, and she disqualified the winner because that she supports Trump. She goes, I can't make this a winner when someone's, you know, who goes against the beliefs I do. Here's the thing, okay? This eyeliner was made in Germany. Here's my thing. Like, if you're such a supporter of, like, you know, anti-Trump and, like, you know, and all this, like, I think you would have your things made in America. Like, Jeffree Star, all his eyeshadows and all his lipsticks and everything, they're made in here in the USA. And I think, like, another thing, too, like, her tattoo liner, right here, her liquid eyeliner that I love, okay? It says it's made in Korea. Her Shade and Light contour palette is made in the USA. You're like, so this is like, some things of hers are made in the USA, others are not. Like, and actually, hell, even the Better Than Sex mascara, it's made in Italy. Like, I guess my whole argument is like, just have things made in America. When you're sitting there, like, supporting, you know, you're like, that you supposedly immigrated from, you know, like, I think my understanding is she immigrated from Mexico to here. Like, she's, like, her parents are, like, Argentinian, and then, like, she's, like, Argentinian descent, and she was born in Mexico herself, and then immigrated here to America. I guess just my whole thing is, like, just get makeup that's made here in America, because I don't think they have the regulations and everything the U.S. does. Like, I don't know if I will be supporting Kat Von D for much longer just because her things aren't really made in America. Like, you know, and I don't know, maybe it's just me rambling. I could be completely wrong about the facts. But I'm just, like I said, I'm just looking, like, her Nosferatu. This is the box that, you know, that, like I said, this is an argument for another day. It's made in Italy. It's made in Italy, you know, I think Kat Von D can do better. I think she can make all her stuff here. But anyways, we will get into the video. Aside from ranting about things made in America, but anyways, this is a new Kat Von D, Billy Joe Armstrong, collab, you get Basket Case. His name is called the Basket Case Anti-Precision Eyeliner in the shade Insomniac Black. You get 1.4 grams or 0.049 ounces. And when you roll it out, you get that much, which is kind of a lot, actually. You get the little pointed tip, like so, if you can see. Let's put that down. And, you kind of get the end, you get like a little sharpener. I don't really like using these, it's just personal preference, but I already have my makeup on. Actually, I was at work today, and I tried it, and I put a little bit on, but it seems all rushed off because I was preparing onions, and we all know how that goes out. But, anyways, no, go away. Damn computer. Sometimes I like computers and sometimes I don't. Anyways, put it here under the waterline. So creamy, it goes on so smooth. That's what my eye looks like. I don't know if you can tell. Go to the other eye. Kind of looks like that. It actually did. This is like, just, we'll do a little swatch here and, you know. But, like, that's pigmented. Like, that's very, very pigmented. I will be doing another video. Like I said, like, look at the eyes. It's a very nice eyeshadow. Like, I kind of rub it around on my hand a little bit, and it kind of does smudge a little bit. I think, if I remember the video, or the release video that she was coming on Basket Case, it said that, she, like, it was like, you're supposed to just kind of have fun with the eyeliner. Like, it says anti-precision, but the next video I'm thinking about doing is another, just kind of a shade and light tutorial with her shade and light palette. I honestly, I like the packaging of this. Oh, it's just so pretty. But, the thing is that I haven't found the right contour shade. Like, I've been using this and apparently it's too light, or at least according to my friends. I'm thinking about, like I said, I'm just gonna kind of play around with this for a couple days. And, see what actually will work out for me. Who knows? I've been using this brush, which is from Red and Wild. It's supposedly a powder brush, but I've been kind of using it as my contour brush. It works. I mean, it does work. But, let me know in the comments what you think of this new Basket Case eyeliner. I would say it's definitely approved. Like, this is definitely, like, Lisa Axel approved. Like I said, just my whole, like, not to vent, but the whole thing is, like, I think, like, you should, like, she should have her products made in the USA. Like, not just some of them. I think it should be all of her products. And granted, the Basket Case, wherever the box went, it is cruelty-free. It is vegan. Well, I don't know. Because it's supposed to have a little, if it's cruelty-free, I was could have swore that it was supposed to have a button, like a little bunny that says free, which means cruelty-free. But I'm not seeing it, which is kind of weird. Like, I see vegan, but where's her cruelty-free? Like, isn't there like a cruelty-free thing? Could have swore. And she claims that she's cruelty-free. Like, let's see on her. Oh, it doesn't even. Oh, well, this is interesting. She has no vegan thing on her boxes either. This is off of her Nosferatu. Interesting. Very, very interesting. Just kind of, and like, let's go to the shade and light box. You know? It says vegan. Like, it says right there, it's vegan. But where's the cruelty free? That's interesting. I'm gonna have to do more research and get back to you. Even, like, let's check out the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. This doesn't even say it's vegan free. This is vegan. This is interesting, guys. Dun, dun, dun. This is very interesting. I never even noticed this. Now, yeah, this came out of my Too Faced mascara. It basically just gives a little info about it. But, yeah, it's very interesting. You would think that if, like, you're selling your stuff, especially if you promote cruelty-free, that there'd be something here on the box. It says vegan, but it does not say anything about cruelty-free. It's interesting. Let's get back to you. But anyways, this concludes the video of the day. I hope you like it. Like, subscribe, and enjoy my channel. P.S. Okay, so when I was talking about the cruelty-free on the Kat Von D boxes, I actually pulled out one of my boxes from Jeffree Star. And if you look there, he has the bunny. Look at the bunny, the cruelty-free bunny. Yeah. So I just wanted to point that out, a little P.S. saying that, like, I'm not making this up to support Jeffree. This is definitely not a sponsored video because I definitely do not have the views or the subscribers to have this a paid thing. But it's just something I've noticed a little bit. So a little bit of evidence for you. But anyways, hope you guys have a good day.